Welcome.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello. Welcome to Super Best Friend. No, wait, what? No.
No, it's the Mother's Basement panel.
Oh.
Thank you.
Thank you for inviting us on, Geoff, because you actually did, so.
For those of you who are here to see these guys, I'm Geoff Thew, professional shitbag. This... this is not my mother's basement. The lights are a lot brighter here, and it's making my eyes shrivel up a little bit, but that's...
You're going to make it. You'll be okay.
I'll be okay. I've got, I've got my security sweater. but yeah, today we're here to sit down, talk about some great intros to video games. Not necessarily the best. I know it said the best in your programs, but...
These are our, like, 12 favorite, kind of now.
Like of right now, as of today, when we plan the panel.
So it's very much, like, subject to change.
No, the title of this event has changed many times over the course of the day, from the best ever objective, you can't ever argue with it, to, like, they're kind of okay, please don't hate us.
Yeah. And just to be fair, it did take me... 6 months to compile the best anime openings of all time into a list. So
and this was like barely 4 hours.
Yeah,
it was a 12 like Angry Men situation. Yeah. We kind of sat there and chose what hills to die on. So,
but we got some good intros for you.
Yes.
Just before that, MAGfest has instructed us to read these small messages to guests and panelists. Dear guests and panelists. Please tell your audience to download guidebook to
underline,
make them aware.
Underline, guidebook.
You guys aware
guidebook,
now?
That's underlined.
Cool.
Fill out the feedback section on guidebook to help improve MAGfest for everyone. That includes all of you. Please talk into the microphone.
Underline.
We record these
things. That one's probably for us.
So please use the mic.
That's probably.
Repeat questions into mic for recording if they weren't already by the asker. I don't think we're going to have the time or ability.
So, unfortunately, because this is like openings, we have a very like rigid schedule here, so we're not going to have time for Q&A or anything today. And that's probably better, because like it would be a pain if people were coming up and they're like, why wasn't the Katawa Shoujo opening on your list?
Sorry, out of time.
Sorry.
Out of time. Gotta go.
I fought for you. I fought G2G. For you. But.
And which, I guess, explains the last one, which is keeping track of time. So,
keeping track of time.
Without further ado, I suppose.
We should get rolling with this.
Do you have a spiel for this one?
Here's an intro that's pretty cool, I think.
Yeah. That I hope... Okay, so I got to go...
Yeah, there's a play button in the one corner.
Yeah.
You have a monitor down there.
Okay, I see. That makes it easier. I did it!
Transcending history and the world, a tale of souls and swords.
It's good, right?
Eternally retold.
It's hard not to pick
some version of a Soul game.
Yeah.
Soul Calibur in particular. Soul Calibur 2. This is the one that I wanted to go with.
Yeah. This is not quite the one you wanted to go with.
Wait, where the fuck's Link?
Oh god!
Who fucks that?
Wrong intro! Oh no! No, it's fine. That's a Hayashi. But to shine, the Soul Blade intro is one of the greatest of all time. It stands out, and it's definitely an example of how Namco's team stood ahead of the crowd when it came to cinematic presentations of their games.
Their CG has always been top quality, and we actually wrestled a little bit with like Tekken 5 as well, like which Namco intro to put in.
Oh, God, Raphael stumbling drunk through the alley is great.
Namco fighting intro.
And to shine is especially notable. It's mainly notable because of
Necrid, Todd McFarlane,
because of the time frame that it came out in. But like, I feel like Soul Calibur 2. Is just a better version of a lot of what that intro was about. Here they had like just perfect introductions of CG characters and things like that. Fighting games kind of have an ability to... they're kind of lucky in that fighting games and RPGs have a lot of characters that they get to introduce to you in a short period of time. So they just really get to like show you the character doing something iconic so you understand exactly what they're about in 2-3 seconds. Like this guy, what's his deal? He's the last samurai. He hates swords and bullets. You know, he loves swords. He hates bullets. Yeah. And he's a badass. That's all you need to know. You know? It's great. And, yeah, like...
This is a fairly straightforward intro. As a fighting game, it is a character montage.
Exactly.
So it's not really breaking any molds. And I actually find that character montages work a little better in games than in anime. I don't know why, but yeah. I just feel that way. Well, maybe it's just because fighting games have that feel.
I think, like, in a fighting game, especially, the characters are the most important part. You don't really care about the story in a fighting game. You just want to know
often not
which guy you want to spend 40 hours learning first.
Yeah, and I think musically as well, you need something that stands out and delivers on that. And I liked that intro song enough to use it as the intro to Fighterpedia.
Absolutely.
So I'm definitely going to say Soul Calibur 2 is worth it.
Yeah.
The only bummer with that intro is the guy doesn't say Soul Calibur 2 at the
Soul
end. And I always
Calibur
feel like he's going to.
2.
Title screen only.
It's great.
So we had some like arbitrary rules we tried to impose on some of these.
Yeah.
We tried to look for intros that aren't cut-ups of gameplay. Mm-hmm. So like Nier is cut from that because that's mostly
Or like FMVs just being cut together.
Or yeah, FMVs or trailers like Street Fighter Cross Tekken that were cut up for the intro. We tried to like look for original openings and stuff, like this kind of stuff.
Yeah, so. I really wanted to put Valkyria Chronicles in here, but that's like all cutscenes from the game.
Right.
So yeah, when we were watching it, there were characters lip-flapping with no audio and just music playing over, so it wasn't super impressive. Yeah.
And similar for something like Smash Brothers Brawl, where it's like, that's a great intro with tons of great music.
The song's incredible.
Mostly cuts, though, from Subspace Emissary.
Yeah. And then tons of gameplay for 5 minutes. So
some of the other like rules we're thinking is like, it has to be before you press start. You know, if it's after you press start, it's technically like...
That's the intro cutscene,
of
the
game.
That's like a different...
Doesn't technically count. So, sorry, Snake Eater, unfortunately. You know, but doesn't count.
Everybody leaves.
I know, it's done.
So Geoff,
let them wait to the end.
This next one's yours a little, and I know you struggled with picking which one was the right one. Boy, there were a lot. So
there are a lot. Maybe if we've got a bit of time afterwards, I can show you how similar some of them are.
Similar, huh?
Yeah. But we're taking a look at the intro to.
Don't say it.
You'll see. Yeah.
So a big reason this clinched it for us was the music, which really stands above the majority of Tales music, honestly.
This is Tales of Zestiria.
Zestiria. Don't worry. I don't need anything I can't pronounce.
So there's a bit of a formula to some of the Tales game intros.
Like that cliff.
Really?
That cliff right there is in every Tales game intro.
Yeah.
That same cliff.
Yeah.
Even
when we thought we were watching one that had none, at the last second they threw
run up to the cliff.
Last second cliff.
There's also a lot of like little girls in meadows because they're innocent flowers.
Yes.
But this
not one, not two, but three turnaround shots.
For me. This breakdown is what makes this opening for me. Like, the action in this is so much better than most of the other Tales games.
Yeah. Well, look at the shot coming up.
Yeah, that ground explosion.
The next one. Look at this Tifa shot.
It just keeps going.
That's Advent
and
Children.
I just want to, like, point out, like, when you showed me this, like, the boldness of the musical choice. It's, like, really soulful music. It's not, like, sort of typical J-rock or J-pop, and I love that. Like, I feel like I can listen, like, the way the music comes together, I can almost hear, like, Alicia Keys singing over this, you know? Like, it's really solid music.
Honestly, I think this intro would be nothing if it had just a regular J-pop song or something more in line with the regular Tales.
It really pulls it together.
And this is, like, a more, like, spiritual tale story, too. Yeah. So ties together.
That's
really
a great shot.
That's a really good shot. So, like, that's the one point where this is, like, hitting the gameplay. Because the big gameplay mechanic in this is that Shiro, the main character, can equip the other characters as, like, suits of armor.
Yeah,
and get more powerful and do special moves.
And there's your clip.
I gotta lean in harder.
And so, like, you have bits that actually introduce some of the gameplay mechanics, right? A good intro, in theory, Tales of Zestiria, that's good stuff.
Yeah.
A good intro, in theory, like, introduces all gameplay mechanics, introduces characters, has really good music, has a really good... it does. So there's so much that you have to consider. The perfect intro does all of these things.
And foreshadows the story without, like, giving it away. That's right, really important.
And honestly, like, I think this one is, like, it's incredibly by the numbers, the animation. But the CG and the, like, anime quality itself is extremely high. It really is. And it's, like, high quality by the numbers, but the music is really what puts it over, kind of, as something that's really special. And, like, I know Tales is, like... traditional boring anime intro, but we still kind of felt like we needed to take a peek over and there. Who doesn't like at least one of those intros? So.
And it's a very well done version of the traditional boring anime intro. Like, even better...
The execution,
than,
right?
Yeah, like, it's even better at traditional boring anime intro than Arc System Works, and they're really, really good at that.
Yeah, yeah. Because we went through those.
And I was going to say that, you know, usually you analyze, like, anime intros that have tons and tons of meaning hidden in them and such, that... Games, unfortunately, don't necessarily deliver that consistently, but at the very least, if they can, like, consider some of that in what they present to you before you press start, it's noteworthy, which is, I guess, some of what we have
and
coming
you do,
up.
And you do see a little bit of, like, plot details coming forward in how it's cut together. Like, you see the assassins early on, even though they're not revealed until much later in the game. So there are bits of story foreshadowing, but you're not going to see the same level of depth that you see in something like Full Metal Alchemist,
right?
In most video game intros.
I'd say this next one is a really good example of capturing the feeling
of
the adventure you're about to go on.
This one's a little bit of an older one. We tried to vary it up. I hope some of you are familiar with it.
Yeah, this is an absolute classic.
Omega.
Absolute classic.
Is this a best friends panel now?
Like, yeah.
Where it just falls apart?
Absolutely, we're here.
Hard enough work to download them, okay? I couldn't be bothered to strip out all of the YouTube nonsense.
I hope there's annotations.
Thank you, Omega. wasn't a hard pick. As soon as someone said it, this was not a hard pick.
This was an instantaneous, like, we have to...
Watch it to validate it, but nothing more.
Like, as soon as that music started playing, we were all like,
yes. Done, sold. So this is the Legends version, but the only difference is the title card. Otherwise, the intro is exactly the same.
This boat disappears abruptly.
It'll just...
Pop.
Yep,
it's gone.
But in 1999, damn it.
It was fine.
It's all in-engine.
It does look like it.
Which
you appreciate, yeah.
I mean, this was meant to play when you played the game, but also the thing with game intros is often they're meant as, like, in-store demos. So this is what this game is capable of. Holy crap, look at how detailed all these environments are.
It's, like, ostensibly a trailer for the game as well, you know?
Yeah.
So.
Like, Sky Pirate established instantly, you know? Kingdom established instantly.
These guys are bad because they're colored black and gray.
Right?
He's bad.
He's really
bad. Behind him. You remember Sephiroth? That's theming.
She's important.
She's a princess, I think. She looks at the moon.
Yeah. And she's from the moon. Yeah. So that's important.
Coincidence? I think not.
No, I think using in-engine, camera work and things for your characters, like...
It's always amazing if you can pull it off.
Exactly, and it makes you appreciate what you're going to play more, especially because you're like, this is exactly what I'm about to see. It's not like an idealized version of it. It's 100% what I'm about to get.
And it really does capture the spirit of the adventure, showing off all the different places in the world. Like, and a huge amount of the cast as well.
Yeah, it's like, this is not a typical RPG. You're going to have, like, ship combat with your flying ships.
Vice is confident.
And like, this combat is so bombastic and dynamic to look at, which is, again, something that the PS1 generation really couldn't do with 3D JRPGs.
Yeah,
like, they look kind of cool, but...
It struggled with it.
Yeah.
That's actually the end of that intro.
Yeah,
that is the end of the intro, and then
what
it just
plays...
What,
does this go into
the opening? Dude, I want to ditch this panel and just play right now. Like,
can leave this
can we just do that?
Keep talking. Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess it loops again.
I guess it's gonna loop. That's fine.
Yeah.
Didn't have time to cut these videos down.
But
thank you, Omega.
Thank you, Omega.
Yeah. Yeah.
Big ups to Omega.
You're the real hero here. Mm-hmm. A big part of that intro is like showing off the different environments, because at the time there had never been a JRPG with 3D environments of that quality, mm-hmm. Where there was like storytelling going on.
Maybe
in each environment.
Maybe I'm not. Yeah, I'm not sure.
Like there have definitely been like pre-rendered ones that looked that good, but.
Sega was pushing next gen early, and it was impressive. Mm-hmm. And it still is an impressive game to this day. So.
And I think like if Skies of Arcadia were like a Saturday morning cartoon show, that's the kind of intro I'd watch every episode to get into the spirit of let's go on a space sky adventure. You know,
it's look at those villains. I hate them so much.
Exactly. You know, it's great.
So this next one on the list is a real wild card, and Woolie really wanted to get this on there. I don't think me or Geoff watched it to validate it. We just knew it, and we said, I remember that being amazing. So crossing my fingers
here. It struck a chord with me. I still think it holds. I don't know. Let's see. I don't know. Maybe it doesn't hold up.
I think it holds up.
I'm second guessing myself.
We'll see. This one's a bit different.
We'll go.
Let's go. Go. It's fine.
Yeah, okay. Some people know it.
Right?
Yeah, this is so good.
I was not expecting at all when I popped in Rock Band 1 that you'd get this really well thought out journey of your band starting out on a crappy car falling apart. You know, he's leaning into the wind. It's great.
Yeah, and it would have been so easy to just go with like a reality show rise to fame kind of thing with the manager, with the contract. They
right?
Sign it,
they
so. Signed
you. You could have had exactly like, oh, you start out in your mom's basement and now, well, and then, you know, and then like, oh, you get picked up more fans and now you're going to sign a thing and now you're flying to Hollywood and recording and you could have done that.
With this abstraction.
Who wants to do that? You can stay in your mom's basement. Still make money.
There you go. And but instead, you go creative with it. You switch vehicles and you land on a truck or a van, for that matter, because your career is stepping up a little bit. You know,
absolutely.
And
they ride this fucking. I would
but
never get on
the
that.
Road to stardom is like a little bit dangerous, and sometimes
it's rocky.
It's rocky.
It's unstable.
It moves fast.
You guys.
It's on the nose, but it is really cool how like it's like you're moving forward,
and then you take
a
leap of faith. You don't know what's gonna happen.
Yeah.
Maybe we should just quit our jobs. Maybe we should quit our jobs and become superstars.
Insane. Right? No, now you're Rock Band.
Yeah,
Rock
now
Band.
You are Rock Band.
God, I love this intro, man. It was so well thought out.
I'm glad because I have not seen that intro in years. Until now, totally holds up.
You know,
super good pick. Honestly, super good pick. And that is the first. Of many Western games on our list.
So. haven't we hit both of them by now, actually?
That was the last Western game on our list. We talked about
No,
that.
We got one more. We got one more.
What?
There is others. But
I didn't write that one down.
Yeah, you missed it.
Okay, we did add a second one, a shotgun second one.
Yeah.
But no, I think Harmonix in general, they, you know, they like their intros were pretty good as well. Cause and like some of these music games as well, it wasn't Harmonix, it was EA. But we're thinking about like how DJ Hero had a really cool intro as well. Mm-hmm. We took a look back at that.
That was Activision that did that one. But yeah.
Right. Excuse me. But no, I think this Rock Band one, like when I first popped it in and saw that, it was like. Okay, I'm with my friends. I'm ready to go on an adventure and just play, you know? Mm-hmm. It was perfectly tone setting. So let's on to the next one, eh?
Yeah.
One right away, This is another Woolie pick.
Yeah, this is one that...
it hits me in the feels.
Near and dear to your heart.
It hits me in the feels for a couple of reasons. The ending in particular.
Uh-huh. Someone said dead or alive.
Dead or alive, exactly.
You know
this
it.
Guy knows it.
This guy knows it. This guy knows it. This intro, when this first happened, I played this on repeat on my MP3 player for such a long time. This is the intro to Namco X Capcom. And
not Project Cross Zone.
Not Project Cross Zone, before that. So like right off the bat, they introduce a couple of, you know, they're original characters that are new to this game. And they're surprisingly not terrible, because a lot of the time original characters tend to be.
A lot of the OG characters, too, that this company makes.
But
I love Klonoa just popping up there in the background.
With all the heroes and the knights, right? You kind of group.
And then Arthur loses his
armor.
perfect.
The Akuma Hill, whatever the fuck that is.
Mount Tennoji.
Yeah. But what's amazing is that, like, not only do they, like, capture all these characters, they get what they're about in just a few seconds.
Yes.
Yeah,
yep,
exactly.
That's what they're
great
about.
Timing, great timing.
Right? All the space heroes, you know what I mean? Like, all the guys blown up, Cosmos goes in.
Yeah.
All the warriors.
Oh, Trigger, I miss you.
Strider,
I miss you, Mega Man.
Captain Corridor, you know, like... Awesome explosions and animation in general. Your typical anime shot, the Valkyrie's got to cry.
Yeah.
Darkstalkers.
Darkstalkers with high contrast.
Yeah,
the art style,
art style.
Changes just for that moment.
Cheer in the wind. Anime.
Anime. Right. Then your fighters come in.
Yeah.
Bravo Man. You guys love Bravo Man, right? What?
This is very Gainax.
Yeah.
Yeah, kind of.
Very much so. In fact, I'm not sure who makes it, but I've
gun people.
It's possible that they got them.
I wouldn't be surprised if it was. Like.
And then again, your original villain, Saya.
OC villain, do not steal.
Who's, again, not that bad. Like, they're pretty cool when you get through the story.
Actually,
but this part is what gets to me. It's like the heroes are all defeated.
And
you know,
heartbeat,
you get the heartbeat
the
going,
the
and everyone's just like, come on, guys, we got to do this. We got to fight together. And if you play far enough through the 300 missions in the game, you eventually kind of get this feeling throughout some of them where they're like, we got to do it together, guys. And
I got this feeling like 40 minutes into Project Cross Zone.
Yeah, you know, Cosmos opens her eyes, they sync up, and we're all going to do our final attacks together to defeat the villain. And it's just great. It's just great. I love it.
MapQuest
Capcom, you rule.
That might actually have been done by Imaishi.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow, cool.
Well, that would explain it.
Which makes sense, because I was looking at some of the spinning and pirouetting and the last shots with the OC characters.
And
it looked really nice.
The video kind of cuts off at that point, but like when you play the game, right at the end of that moment where the music fades out, it loads in that title screen where you're hearing a remixed version of the theme you were just listening to in the intro, so it sounds really good as well. And then when you begin Mission 1, it's a third remix of that song again. So you're just like, you're on this momentum train that never stops from the moment the intro starts. It keeps going all the way through your first mission, and it's fantastic.
Yeah. So I just looked it up, and I confirmed that Imaishi did do Namco X Capcom.
Who is credited for doing also.
He also did part of some of the cuts for Tales of Symphonia.
Okay.
And Samurai Legend.
But for those who don't know, who is this guy?
Imaishi is the guy behind Space Patrol Luluco. The greatest show of the last year.
Yeah, absolutely.
Also, he did, what was the name of that? That one anime.
Lawnmower
Man.
It's
on the tip of my tongue. It's got drills in it.
Space Drill Guys.
That sign.
Something about Tengen Toppa Gurren Lagann?
Yeah.
Perhaps, maybe, I don't know.
Nah.
That guy.
Yeah. No, Dead Leaves. It's Dead Leaves.
Oh, okay.
But,
right.
And
cool. That's great. It shows, honestly. Like,
yeah.
There was some cuts in there where I was like, huh, that looks familiar.
Like, when they're running together to, like, clash swords, that's
his style.
He used that in Kill la Kill.
And the cross.
He just straight replaced the characters.
The cross explosion. Yeah. Like, it makes sense. There's some telltales there, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So this next one is not really as, like, haute anime. It's a little bit schlocky, you might say.
But we were talking about how not a lot of these intros have a lot of plot details in them, and this is full of plot. Yeah. There is so much plot in this intro.
This is a fun intro
that is for all the family.
Okay. And has full of, it's full of plot.
Tons of plot. And some hometown. Can we turn up the music a little bit on that one?
I'll turn it up a little.
So, plot. Plot is happening.
But no, really.
There's Liam.
Yeah.
I think they're hearing it out there.
I hope you guys can hear it.
Yeah, I think they can. Do you wanna kind of get into it a little bit,
like,
Liam?
A lot of, like, fan service anime openings are just that, and they just kind of end, and you're like, yeah, okay, that was cute, and that was kind of sexy, right? This one, in its, like, final third right after this, starts going places and places. Is really interesting. So just enjoy this after this.
Going places such as third base, second base, and sometimes home.
So this is it's about food, right? That's the theme of this game. And cooking. So what we're seeing is cooking related things, but Liam,
but
sell it.
It's Liam, full life. Sell it. It's just packed with life. What do you want me to say?
So much plot
and tons of hometown for good measure.
creative uses of food.
Those sushi rolls represent sushi rolls and nothing else.
So I genuinely think this is like the best opening for a fan service like anime style game. So Senran Kagura, bon appetit.
Yeah. It's got a fun escalation though, because like at first they have no idea how to cook, and then by the end they're using their ninja skills to not cook and take off their clothes.
Yeah, and the normal Senran videos, there's the not cook and take off your clothes because there's no cooking. But it's also just like regular anime fighting. It's not special. This intro I find is really funny, and I'm glad I heard a couple chuckles from a few of you out there. So that was good. Who's best girl? I don't know, like Mirai
Daidoji?
Or something. Yeah. Daidoji's great.
Daidoji.
Too, so.
This next one is the other Western intro. It therefore needs to be shunned, of course.
Yeah.
But
this one's very different.
Yeah, this one's got more of a story focus, less of a music focus. But we decided to pick it because it does really highlight a lot of aspects of gameplay while also capturing the tone of the type of media that the game is trying to emulate.
So if you're familiar with the game, just while you're watching it, just keep an eye out for how many straight gameplay mechanics
Because
there's a lot in there. And even like design ideologies of how the game works. It's really, really cool.
And also some very quotable lines, which some of you are free to quote as they come up in this cutscene.
Yeah.
It's left for dead.
Hold up.
I actually completely like forgot about these cinematic intros until we talked about them earlier
like
today.
Before. Jesus, don't let that stop you from smearing it all over yourself.
I think some people were anticipating something.
They're changing.
Ah, watch.
Oh.
Damn it, Bill. Oh, it stinks.
But what you kind of get, I guess, with these sorts of intros is like less of a music video and more of just like a cinematic moment in this world. Mm-hmm. That'll tell you what these characters are about and what you're going to be doing in this game.
And we looked at the Left 4 Dead 2 intro as well, because it is similar in a lot of ways.
Yeah.
But the reason we chose this one over Left 4 Dead 2 is Left 4 Dead 2 has a lot more like quick cuts to different scenes, and we kind of liked the continued narrative of this this opening.
And like this is really very suspenseful.
This is shot like a film.
Please feel suspenseful right now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Right.
Yeah.
Shit.
No, like that's the thing is like they each special zombie gets a little bit of screen time to kind of just sort of get you like familiar with what their gimmick is going to be.
Yeah. And you also like learn the pictures of bullets fun.
Maybe don't look at the lip.
The lifters are trying to isolate you right away. Don't go in the room.
Merry Christmas.
Like I said, a lot of portable action movie lines.
Yeah, you see all the characters' different weapons. You see this come out. You see them. They all run for it. This is teaching you how to play.
Teaching you how to play.
You're learning right now.
It's edutainment.
Edutainment, that's it.
Make your way to the escape, you know?
And don't
Lewis is gonna run off
alone.
That's a good idea, right? No.
Damn it!
It's teaching you.
The red light implied it was a mistake to go alone.
Yeah. That means dead. Down but not dead state. That's a thing.
This is gonna get bad.
Down but not dead. You're super right. Yep. Yeah, that's true.
Bleeding out state.
Like everything's
very important.
the final swarm before the mission is over that happens. There's always the last phase. You're seeing a cinematic representation of what a mission is like.
What it feels like to play the game.
Yeah.
And then, of course, there's that setting line. Thank you.
Run or shoot?
Run or shoot?
Both.
Run or shoot? Both. That's the whole game, basically.
And I think when we were comparing it to the second intro, for the intro for the second game had it was more quotable, and the start and the end of that were really fun, but this overall does a much better job of like feeling like gameplay.
Yeah, I think the characters in the second one, just personal opinion, I think they're a little more charismatic than these guys, but I love these guys. So there's some really good gags in the second one. They really are. But this, like, this connected narrative is, like, single scene is a lot better than the like multiple scenes in the second one, I felt. Yeah. Besides the fact that it is more representative of gameplay as well.
And then that's just one.
We made it. I can't believe we made it.
Son, we just crossed the street.
Yeah.
Let's not throw a party until we're out of the city.
Yeah, you know, like, zombie games, you kind of don't even need that much setup for it, because it's just like guns, zombies, go. But they went further with it, and
I
applaud
that. It's a thoughtful intro.
I think they did a really good job with it.
I like how it takes you right into the start of No Mercy, too. Like, like you're on that rooftop.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I haven't played that in a long time.
All right, what's next?
So that is actually the last Western one.
That is, yeah. We're now done.
You were spared from Mortal Kombat Armageddon,
and we can go. Yeah.
Which is a great intro.
Yeah. Now,
although we may start playing that to get you out of here at the end of the panel.
Yeah.
Full on weeb mode engage. Yeah.
So this one's a neat JRPG that maybe not a lot of people played. So hope you enjoy it. I think it's a very cool intro.
This is one of the few that just sort of shows up. Starts immediately, so
I see.
It may already be spoiled for some of you who have played it a lot, but there we go. This was a very underrated DS.
Yeah, very late in the DS's lifetime. Yeah.
If any of you played Tale Cut Sherco on PS1, this was a spiritual successor.
If you haven't, that's okay. Not many people did.
Nobody did. But I love Castle in the Sky.
This echoes a lot of that, yeah, for sure.
No, and as someone who I haven't played the game, I'm unfamiliar, but like seeing this cutscene, I was like, oh, this is a cool world. This looks interesting. There's
songs.
I'm very curious about the setting and what's going on, and like I think the sequence of like character introductions and mecha introductions and battles is
ride robots
strong.
Around on airships. And also you shoot, and also you slash, and also it's great. Go play this game.
And this animation is beautiful.
Animation is tremendous. And it's decimated by the DS's screen.
Yeah.
If you watch it on the original system. I guess this was a trailer or something.
Yeah, this must have been the trailer cut.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We should have used the original resolution. Kept it real.
The 240p DS resolution.
Is it that shit?
Good musical choice, right?
It's hinting at the world's mythology.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, this is a world of furries. Why are there humans? What's it all about?
What are people up to?
Yeah.
We can use a few cuts because poverty. AKA regular.
But like while there are a few clips, it's mostly phenomenal.
Yeah, and fun mechanical designs throughout this. Like, I like what's going on.
Those plane robots, they look.
And I believe, a Cranky Construct, I was talking to him just before this, and he was telling me that like when you beat the game, a second intro unlocks that reveals more as the plot sort of opens up.
I think it's a whole extra minute and a half.
You should have told me about that, Liam, so I could download it.
No. No, that's...
Because that's spoilers.
That's mad spoilers.
But that's super cool.
This already has, like, more spoilers than it should, but...
yeah.
That was a pick of mine that I hope some of you guys think is cool.
The next one is... this is... If there's any intro hill that I'm going to choose to die on...
This one.
It's going to be this one. Let's just go.
Yeah.
Let's just go.
Did you get the good version?
I hope you got the good version.
This is a film, by the way. So
this is basically a short film leading into the game.
This is the longest one by far. So please enjoy.
I just needed this. I needed this.
We all needed this.
This is actually the opening too.
Uh huh.
Oh, this. Yeah, this is a little game called Onimusha 3.
Yeah.
You may have heard of it.
And if you haven't seen the intro to it, it's just like... Well,
Please enjoy the film.
Thank you. Large creature has a brain thing in it. I wonder if that's important.
That creature is a level.
Yeah. This was what, circa 2005?
Ooh, let's get an exact date on that, because, yeah, that'll actually...
And it still looks tremendous.
Yeah.
That'll actually...
Great use of motion capture here.
2004.
Yeah. The animation quality is definitely what holds up.
So that's gameplay. You know, you make your way through hordes and power up. And when you power up, you get the ability to do things like that.
But this was one of the earliest games to, like, capture an actual actor. And
yes.
Stuff.
Yeah. Well, and they were very proud of that in this game.
To the
they got a very, very big French Canadian actor to do it.
Yes.
He is French Canadian.
No, he's France.
Oh, he's just French. France? That's not real.
But no, at the time I was just like watching this, like, what, like, this is a movie. Like, I games don't usually do this, especially.
Well, and for the next game, they made a CG movie. Like, they actually did continue after this.
That
the same
still
studio that
looks
did it.
Pretty good.
The only thing that doesn't look good in this intro is the liquids, and even then, they're not miserable. So.
Like
fuck! Look at this.
Oh, you're so pretty.
So handsome.
Yeah.
I mean, Link now still looks good, but the moblins have let themselves go.
Right. And now you're doing things that are way cooler than gameplay, but still, like, I'll allow it, man.
Leave him be. I'll take care of him.
Galaganto.
We meet again, Zamanoske.
You shall not meet Nobunaga.
Dodge.
The fight choreography is so strong.
Yeah. It's
fun. Hasn't aged a day.
No. No. And I remember when we were discussing it, I was worried because I was like, I haven't seen this in so long.
Yeah, what if it's weak?
What if it doesn't hold up? And then we watch it and it was like, no, it absolutely does.
Like, I mean, it's no Mortal Kombat Armageddon.
No.
Like, if anything, it's the flaw is it sets your expectations a bit too high of the game. You know, possibly.
Like, you can't possibly be impressed with the game as much as you are with the intro.
Did this
intro even come with a game?
They sold it separately.
I thought it was just an intro on this.
Oh, he killed the brain, and that was the important part. Like, this is what Lord of the Rings would call a leggy moment. The legless
moment.
Okay,
so this bit is certified stupid.
Certified awesome. Yeah.
Safe. All right. I think Geese Howard did that with, like, Republicans toward the ground one time.
It ain't over.
It's not.
Did you think it was over? Did you think it was done?
Act 2.
This is Onimusha 3,
motherfucker. This is actually a movie.
His hair didn't turn white yet, bitch. Keep watching. It's like, yeah, all those souls cash in on them.
That game mechanic, bring it back.
Yeah.
How many is that? A lot.
Super Saiyan God Super Saiyan.
Big.
You know, it's fine. Get ready for the longest, no, craziest, dragged out fight.
The realest fight.
This fight is so long and dragged out, it's amazing. They do so much, like... It's done. It's done. You got nothing. Yeah.
You get to play as that guy. You get to play as that guy.
And you also get to play as
someone else.
Someone else.
Oh, wait. I hope you got the good version of the trailer, because we'll find out.
Nobunaga's like, what happened?
I'm also, sure I did.
Like, cool guys don't look at explosions. Cool guys stand in the explosions.
Yeah.
Mind you.
Yeah.
No, it's a short film. It really is.
Nobunaga, why you look so cool?
Why is your ambition so great? That guy! And...
Yeah!
Hey! That guy!
Jean Reno,
what are you doing here? Back to back! Yeah, Onimusha 3, guys. It's a fucking great intro.
Just fucking awesome.
Love it. Love it.
We gotta roll.
We gotta roll now because it's 6:50 and we're allowed to go over just.
And that was a really long one too. That was our longest one.
Four more to go. We're on track right now.
Yeah.
I don't know.
But yeah, what I like about that intro is that it really sets the tone of like a wuxia or a samurai.
Well, you could call it a demon siege.
Yeah. A demon siege. Yeah. No, but
I'll just level with you here. But what I was seeing on this.
Maybe it was a siege
maybe
of demons.
You might have something there. Yeah, but
I think there was some, like, someone was hired to think about that.
Yeah. It sets it up, but I think, like, again, it might almost be to the detriment where it's like your expectations of the rest of this game are so high now. You can't deliver after that.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. At least they should make more Onimusha for the modern era.
Well, they made another one that wasn't very good.
They made another one, and they're like, we didn't. We don't talk about that. We move forward.
We don't talk about that one.
Okay. Always forward.
Moving on.
We've got a classic.
This one.
The other one that
right
when
away.
It was brought up.
Yeah.
Woolie hates himself for not picking it himself. Yeah. I was the one who brought it
up. When you said this, I think I just applauded.
Yeah.
I think I just applauded
you did.
Your
but
words.
Like,
just hit it, man.
It's great.
Oh, no.
Yes.
Yeah. And it's
a game.
It's another one that moves away from J-pop a little bit in a very, very good way.
For good reasons.
Because anime doesn't have to be J-pop. It doesn't have to be Japanese music distinctly. It can be other styles.
Yeah. It can be something really, really beautiful.
The giveaway.
It can be something Western.
Can anyone whistle in here?
No, it was a choice that we almost completely ignored, and you brought it in, and it was
easy
clutch.
Choice.
You lock it in there. Wild Arms 1.
Wild Arms 1 is...
I hear some people whistling. That's
I mean, bad. All of the Wild Arms games have really good intros. Imaishi did the third one.
We got some determined whistlers in the audience.
It's a tough whistle, but if you can pull it off, do it.
Yeah, I mean, this is as whistleable as the Proto Man.
Not far from it.
So what's going on here?
Everyone's got their own quest. We saw our main character.
So this is a game, if you don't know, where every single playable character has their own sort of story that you do before they loop into the main party.
They become a party.
And so the way that this intro is setting up is that you're following each of these characters on their own before they meet up. You'll also note that she's unleashing all of these lights, which come back later.
Just remember the lights. Don't forget the lights.
Remember the lights.
Character intro. Bam. Now you know her. She's got a thing.
I miss this style of animation, you know? Like this cell animation.
So our main character, here he is again.
He's climbing this,
climbing this cliffside. What it's going to be tough.
What's the theme? You're climbing cliffside.
So this is his. This is a metaphorical representation of his journey. He's being helped along by the lights.
Damn. Yep.
And as he reaches for the top of the cliff, and we get there, what does he find? He finds the other protagonists having just completed their own...
ascent.
Their own ascent. Man. Their own journey.
Geoff, without you sometimes, I think, like, I would not know what is in an OP.
Yeah.
Like, at all.
Like, I love this intro, and I never caught that they were all climbing and they all got there at the same time.
Yeah.
I thought he just reached them
and now
and they
they're
were
all
standing
stuck
there,
on this shitty
and it's like,
rock.
My friends, yeah. You know.
We gotta climb back down now.
I was fully
but they
on board.
Climb back down together.
Together.
Yeah. No, I was fully on board for, like, the true Wild Arms was the friends we made along the way.
Yeah.
They were waiting up there, but it's like, no, they all got there at the same time because you saw him getting up. Like, good job, man.
Good pick.
Yeah.
Great pick. This intro totally holds up.
Yeah.
And
I, one thing that I really love about this intro is there's like a very thin window of time between when we got storage media that was big enough to have intros on games and everybody decided to go to digital instead of traditional animation.
Yeah.
So this is one of the few cell animated openings that you get to a video game, and it's
worth anything.
Superb.
Yeah,
Superb.
Definitely.
All right.
So this next one. So
just
this game is a bad game. It is a bad game. Please, okay, you got that? Put that over there. This intro is a great intro. You want to certify that? Would you put the Woolie stamp on that?
Please understand.
I put my stamp on that.
Bad game.
Bad game.
Amazing intro.
Fantastic.
Amazing intro with music by a band that is here.
That
at
will be
MAGfest.
Playing immediately after we're done. Actually.
Yeah.
So
you might want to leave.
You
right
might
away.
Run.
But don't. But don't leave.
Don't go.
Don't leave. Stay. You're staying. You're not going anywhere. You're not going anywhere. This intro rules. I don't care what anyone says.
Tell me it's not amazing.
I will fight you.
This intro is so good.
We will all fight you.
Shadow the fucking Hedgehog.
And we
man.
Put
Look
this
him.
In instead of anything from Sonic Adventure.
Yes. Absolutely.
What's this game about, Liam?
This game is about the best hedgehog in the world fighting off aliens with guns. Can you see this, by the way? There's soldiers fighting aliens. There's two distinct factions presented there. Aliens coming down as the lyrics tell you they're falling, right? Soldiers fighting. Aliens fighting.
Black-hearted evil, perhaps?
Black-hearted evil. Brave-hearted hero. I am all I am all I am.
He's all that he is.
And
he's
got
upset in a beautiful a beautiful like scenery, and he's upset. Look, Sonic and Friends, boo.
But all of Sonic and Friends have to come together to equal Shadow the Hedgehog.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
He doesn't have to share a screen with anybody.
Chaos Control, he's letting you know you can't stop him.
Yeah. He also used the Chaos
There's
Control
the enemies.
Teleport earlier.
Can you see all of me walking to my destiny?
Look,
step
look
inside
at,
of all my... Yeah?
Hold on for dear life.
There's the three factions.
Between,
right.
Between Eggman
and the leader of Gun. Soldier.
Yeah. Like they're just as bad as each other.
And it's like, oh, you done fucked
the
up.
Iconic
you
line,
done
I
fucked
am
up.
All
look at that
I am
face.
All I am.
This, Geoff, you did something
Explain
amazing.
This.
Explain.
Okay,
this shot
okay.
is so good.
All right. All right. So.
Pause that shit.
Back it up. Shit up. Okay. Okay, so what's really, really cool,
Rewind.
What's legitimately cool about this shot is in this game, you can choose to be a bad guy or a good guy.
Yeah.
And in this shot, Sonic could have just been shot in the back of the head by Shadow.
Or
he could have just taken a hit for him. It works both ways.
And because you choose which side you're going to be on in the game, it's a neutral shot and you don't know what to make of it.
Moral choices.
Right? And then he moves forward. Shadow the fucking Hedgehog.
Shadow the Hedgehog.
What?
I am all of me. That's it. That, seriously, game's awful, but that intro?
Yeah.
Actually fantastic. And Crush 40 is playing at 7 here.
Yeah.
And if you go to their concert and yell, play Shadow loud and hard enough, They might actually play
yeah,
it.
They might.
Yeah. No, that was a 9 on 10, and until when Geoff pointed that out, he made it an 11. Yeah. Like, you don't know if Sonic took the hit
I
or
can't
if he got
believe,
betrayed.
Like, we watch this intro weekly.
Every time. And we sing it.
All the time. We sing it.
Yeah, yeah.
And we didn't realize that until Geoff pointed it out this morning, that can be interpreted. Like, there's multiple facets.
And there's multiple endings. There's 12 endings in the game.
I knew that.
So, you know, it just plays
all. It all works. Uh-huh. Really, really.
Heads
off.
All right. This next one Liam picked out.
Yeah, this was one I put in. We were looking at Fallout intros, and I decided that I wasn't really happy with the West's take on disaster and post-apocalypse. So I think you might really enjoy this one if you're into anime games and stuff.
And apologies for the aspect ratio, but...
can't help that.
Hey, Dead or Alive guy, it's not Dead or Alive.
Zack Island is all the right. opposite of
And then
disaster.
We got one more after that. It's not Dead or Alive, sorry. Yeah.
It could be Dead or Alive, but it's not Dead or Alive.
Yeah.
Now, this game is beautiful.
Yeah, and I never heard of it until Liam pointed it out.
This was a Wii exclusive JRPG.
Xseed published it, Namco developed it.
And nobody bought it.
Nobody bought it. Sold really badly. It is a fantastic game.
What is it called?
It's Fragile Dreams.
Farewell Ruins of the Moon.
Like, just that sentence you said, like, a gentle take on the apocalypse. I'm like, that's a really interesting thing that makes me want to kind of look into this a little more. Mm-hmm.
And
curious.
They're trying to get to Tokyo Tower the whole time in the game, basically.
Oh, which is why it's there in the bed.
Yeah, exactly. So cool. That's the secret. Really beautiful game, honestly.
Fragile Dreams.
Fragile Dreams, Farewell Ruins of the Moon.
Highly recommended.
Yeah.
And you get to watch that cutscene a lot because it plays at the intro and then it plays like at least at 3 different chapter breaks.
It's been a minute.
It comes a lot.
This next and final one, we have more to say after it than we do
before
it. It needs no introduction.
Yeah.
Hit that shit.
Well, the only introduction is we had to decide which of the games from this series we were going to do.
We're only going to play
and
one.
Because time.
Yeah.
Because
otherwise
it would be the panel of this series.
We could do a whole panel on it. Yeah. It's Dead or Alive. Yeah.
No. Yeah, it's Dead or Alive.
Dead or Alive Extreme 3. So it was either this one or Persona 5, one of the two. And what went this one?
They're all so good. They're all so good. And like I played 3, 4, really at 3 and 4 really close to each other, and then like a lot of the Persona like world for me came together really quickly. So I was blown away by all of them, but this one in particular was the only one where like I was holding the Vita, leaning back like, oh my god, I can't believe how good this looks.
Yeah, definitely. Uh-huh. And this is a really, really plain intro. But the quality of the presentation is what kills it, because right now we've just been doing character intros and like credits.
You're just kaleidoscoping.
It's really, really plain, but the quality.
It keeps going in and in and in, and there's never like a break in the continuity.
That's too.
Zooming.
Nope.
The camera never cuts.
That was a hint at some plot there, but Yeah,
there's a little bit of that. And the scooters, which are the big thing in this version
That's
of the game
new.
That they were selling.
And the glasses.
The weather,
yeah.
the time.
All those
the bonus chapter.
The weather cards, exactly. The things that come into play in the Golden, particularly, you know?
But, like, I love the idea of, like, lenses within lenses.
And it comes
within
back just
lenses.
Like at the beginning of the intro.
And you're, like, going into the TV like they go into the TV.
Yeah. So we could only pick one, and that one we thought
that,
was
it's Persona for the Golden.
The
like,
so.
Come on, it's so good.
Yeah. And hey, the sign guy's got
GA doll now.
Yeah.
Top waifu doll. Good choice. But yeah, I love this intro. It's just so hypnotic the way that it just keeps zooming and zooming and zooming, mm-hmm. and it really draws you in. Like
again, it's very plain what they're doing, but just the quality of the presentation and the layering and the kaleidoscope effect, like it all just adds up to just a
the
gorgeous,
to
gorgeous
one bit.
Opening.
Yeah, yeah. It's you know, I mentioned it earlier, but this is absolutely a game where it's like every time you load your save up on that, you're watching the full intro beginning to the press start. Every time you boot it up,
it's worth it. It's worth it every time.
You might even like shut off your PS Vita just to watch that.
Yeah. Don't go to sleep mode. You're gonna miss that shit.
Yeah. The 5 also has an incredibly strong one. I was pushing for that because it was animated by the lady who directed Yuri on Ice.
Topical.
Which, you know, is an anime that a lot of people love right now. I see a lot of people filtering out in the back. Go enjoy Crush 40.
Yes, please.
They're playing.
But, yeah, like, all of the Persona intros are really good.
And 5 in particular, like, while we don't have the time to play it, there's, like, lots of, like, skating and, like, moments mm-hmm. that look like they're almost, like, the same things that they were doing in Yuri on Ice.
Yeah. Like, so the lady who directed Yuri on Ice was obsessed with skating. And that's why she made
it
Yuri
shows,
on Ice.
So yeah. Okay.
That's why skating shows up in literally everything she does.
Okay.
That makes sense.
And
that's why that intro is so fucking
beautiful. I wish I could remember
so
her name right now
beautiful.
Because I sound super professional.
Wow, well, whatever.
But
that's
I think,
all good. You're at a best friends panel.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. When things go wrong, it's a best friends panel. When things go right, it's a mother's basement panel. Remember that.
Yeah.
But no, I think the Atlas team is just on a visual level. They're like so far beyond the rest of the video game industry.
Mm-hmm.
Everything they do, like UI design wise, graphic design,
it's
like,
all gold.
It's beyond. Yeah. It's platinum. And
ironic.
Everything I've seen from 5, from the like press start screen to the menus, everything is just the best version of that thing I have ever seen in a video game.
Absolutely.
And I hate hyperbole, but
their UI is
tremendous.
Is crack.
Yeah.
But we could literally do an entire panel
on just Persona,
about the Persona intros.
Yeah.
And by the way, you should ask MAGfest to give us that panel next year.
Yeah. So anyway, that was...
fill out the feedback section.
There you go.
On Guidebook.
Yeah.
So that was Geoff Thew's Mother's Basement's Best Friends guest.
Mothership
Liam also guest.
Yes.
Yeah.
Our favorite intros, I guess, of right about now and today.
Yeah.
Tomorrow it'll probably be a different list.
Yeah.
But you'll have to wait till next year to see that.
Please don't leave angry comments.
thank you.
Thanks for coming very much.
Should we do up
thank
in
you.
Japanese now?
Yeah, I think we should.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming out. I hope you enjoyed it. It's my second panel I've ever run, so.
Check him out at Mother's Basement on YouTube. It's a really good channel. It's got great videos analyzing anime OPs and other stuff, and I can't wait to see what you do for JoJo Part 4.
I'm excited to do that.
Check him out at youtube.com/theswitcher with a one instead of an I because they don't know how to brand.
And if you want to know what this anime thing is all about, go to crunchyroll.com/basement to sign up for a 30-day free trial.
Use coupon code WoolieM.
And check him out at Twitter 2BF-Liam.
All right.
Thanks very much.